Alrighty, we have the fabulous Red Winter with us in the Live Lounge today.
Reed Wanted. Reed Wanted.
Reed Wanted, is that the
people have been saying our name wrong for years. it doesn't happen on other shows. Reed Wanted.
Right, okay. So where are Reed Wanted from then?
Stockholm, Sweden. Stockholm, Sweden.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Come on, names, left to right.
Joe.
Phil.
Phil.
Shan.
And Shan. Right, it's been a long time since I've had you lads in, actually. Now, you've been keeping quite busy, haven't you? You've had a few sort of stops and starts with the band, with band members coming in and band members coming out, but you seem like you're at full speed again with it.
Yeah, when Phil came out, we were all made of fun. We saw it coming.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, we have got a few new members of the band, haven't we?
We got Shan on the end.
Shan on the end.
Playing drums. I like fast, I'll introduce himself.
Introduce
I'm Shan. I play drums.
There you go. Shan plays drums.
Well, I like
me. Also the eye candy of the band.
Well, yeah,
that's true.
Apart from Joe, of course, you know what I mean. He is the Roundsound Radio pinup. He's on all the calendars. I think we've even got you on a few mugs. Now, your music is a rare treat for Liverpool, isn't it, guys? You fly the flag high for punk music in the city. Do you feel that the punk scene has grown over the last couple of years?
I don't know if it's grown, it's just changed. It's always been there. I know, is it Sub Pop that operate out of the top end of town by Vulcan and such? But, I mean, we're not really part of that. But we know bands that do similar things, and we just sort of keep in touch with them. And
yeah.
Last year you started up the collection, didn't you?
Yeah.
Instead of Anger Parts, that The Last Reserve and things like that. So you're putting a lot more gigs on, I think, this year, aren't you, yourselves?
Yeah, well, I've just joined Fat Ando. Yeah. With Ando. So we're going to be putting the gigs on under that banner. We did Last of the Reserves last night. With Ominous Flux and with Antisius, whose name I always get wrong.
That is a tricky name, I would get that wrong all day.
Yeah.
But note to be made, that band, if you do send your music in, I will cock your name up.
Yeah, we're Red Winter. I'm Joe. What are you, Phil? You gotta introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Phil.
We're gonna play some songs for you. This first one's called PS Return to Sender, and it's dead good. 1, 2, 3, 4. The story of a life that's ordinary. Tears, stolen love in time to find a way. And I never believed in love, and I never believed in what might be. Waiting somewhere in the night scene. But don't say it's love, but don't say it's so. Don't tell me how to feel. Don't tell me that you don't know. Don't say it's love, but don't say it's so. Don't tell me how to feel. Don't tell me that you don't know. The midtime brings the summer. We've forgotten one another, and the heartstrings burn for nothing. Please, I scream, just give me something. Wanna believe in it all, and I wanna believe in what might be. Wanna scream your name at the top of my lungs, but don't say it's love, but don't say it's so. Don't tell me how to feel. Don't tell me that you don't know. Don't say it's love. Don't say it's so. Don't tell me how you feel. Don't tell me that you don't know. Na 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 na.
Now, you're actually playing a gig tonight, aren't you, in Maguire's Pizza Bar, straight after here. You tend to, as I say, put your own gigs on. Do you find that formula's working better these days?
Yeah.
Are you happy with it?
It's all fairer.
Well, yeah, because you spread the money between the bands. There's no middleman involved.
I mean, also, like, there's a lot of bands that will pay promoters to put on the shows, and the promoters don't do anything at all. Yeah. I feel this way, it's a lot fairer because the bands all get an equal cut of all the profits.
And they also, they're responsible for promoting the gig themselves,
yeah,
aren't they?
Yeah, myself for them.
We stress, obviously, it's not a majority of promoters. A lot of them do a cracking job, and there's like a lot of venues in Liverpool where promoters are doing a great job, but there's a few that don't, and they're the ones who give the other promoters a bad name, and which leads to people doing things like we're doing. I mean, it's a DIY effort. We're a punk rock band. Mm. That's what we're supposed to do.
I do find it crazy sometimes myself. I'll say to bands, you know, so who's on the bill tonight? And they go, don't know. I'm going, you're playing the gig with the rest of the bands, and you don't know who's on the bill. They're like, well, we haven't had a flyer or anything like that, mate. Okay.
Well, yeah, we've made an effort of going out and finding bands like ourselves. I mean, I think most recent is who we've sort of become good friends with is Burn the Airbook.
Yeah.
They're phenomenal. They're going to be sending music into you anyhow.
It's talented before they can actually sing as well.
Oh yeah, they're so talented. Yeah. It's like it's really they got the whole thing, haven't they? Like, the good on playing music, he can sing, and he looks like fucking sex god.
Does he, yeah?
Yeah, Josh. It's just so bad, you know, like me.
Might have to replace you.
A fat ginger. Yeah. And then you look at him, and it's like, that's like a before and after picture. It's horrible. But they're brilliant. And then obviously there's like Last Reserves. We played with a band called Flux last, well, we did, we had a gig with a band named Flux last night. They were weird, like indie punk, aren't they?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's, but they're good. They're a really, really good band. And then obviously they did the funk now, but there was likes of Lost in Translation. And then, who else? Who is I knocking about now? Used to be Crosslight as well. But we're just trying to find the bands who want to play shows. And
well, that's the thing, although you play some of the gigs you put on, you're also just doing that for other bands solely, aren't you?
Yeah.
So you're organising the event, but even though sometimes you might be taking part.
Yeah. Well, I mean, the thing with Fat Ando is Ando doesn't make a penny from the gigs he puts on. He puts the time in himself, and obviously now I'm doing the same thing, but every single penny of it at the moment is going to the band. So the first one we played, we managed to put £60 in every band's pocket after the overheads taken out for the gig. Any band out there, £60 a head.
Brilliant.
Sorry, for a band, that's a great way to start. And it means that the thing that a lot of people don't realise is when you go see a band and you pay to see a band, a lot of the time they take that money and they put it back into making more music. So when you go back and see them a second time, it's new music.
Of course, yeah.
And they've got new stuff to give you.
It's obvious math, isn't it? It pays for studio time, doesn't it? Yeah.
If you like a band, when you go and see them, you're investing in that band's future.
Yeah, of course.
Give them money to get merch as well, to make more money to make more music.
Well, for example, your last single, I'm sure that was coming, you know, you had that professional record, and that was probably due to the kindness of your fans.
It's the first time I ever played this acoustic, so, boss, it's called Autobahn.
And it has been all along. The captain of his own ship, but it never leaves the shore. As he sits round, the phone don't ring and his friends don't call no more. He don't need anybody, he ain't just anybody, he's gonna be somebody soon. He's gonna be somebody soon. He's always so much fun. In his home, he's always the master. the shore. Cause he said drowned in his hometown and his friends don't come no more. He ain't just anybody. He ain't just anybody. He's gonna be somebody soon. He ain't just anybody. He don't need anybody. He's gonna be somebody soon. He's always so much fun. I seen that guy round here the other day. I used to know him back then, but now you don't see him around. He ain't just anybody. He don't need anybody. He's gonna be somebody soon. He ain't just anybody. He don't need anybody. He's gonna be somebody soon. He's always someone's fool.
I noticed you've got a gig coming up very shortly in the Crazy House.
We have, yeah.
I love the Crazy House, mate. I spend a lot of my youth in the Crazy House. I'm definitely coming to that one. How do you go about getting on there as a band?
Well, we're really lucky. It sounds like massive nepotism, isn't it? But our friend Mike Marr is the Crazy House DJ on the K2 floor, and he likes the band. Everything we've ever played has been played in the club. So
he's a fan anyway.
Yeah. They're looking to put more bands on, and we're supporting Green Date, which is a Green Day tribute band.
Super.
So he thinks we fit the bill for a support. So.
Nice that. I mean, I've seen a few quality bands, as I say, in the Crazy House before as well, so I'll definitely be having a nosy on down to that. What are the dates again for that?
22nd of April, it is, and it's £5 in. You can get them through Skiddle, or you can get them from the venue themselves, and it's the ticket for the night, but as well as that, you pay your way into the Crazy House, so you get the club night as well. So if you go in the Crazy House anyhow, you probably pay £3-4 to get in. You may as well pay the extra pound and come and watch two live bands.
Obviously, yeah. It's all sense, doesn't it? And they still charge £1 to go off for Siggy?
No, that's not
that anymore. I stopped going for that, because I used to be a big smoker, and they started that. I was thinking, this is costing me a fortune, this.
This next song is called Some Friend You Were, which is also the single. And with singles, you have to buy them. You can buy ours at all good online retailers. It costs at least 60 pence, but no more than £1. However, you can give more through Bandcamp. And just like the likes of Live Earth, just £1 can make sure a band can buy some noodles from the local studio. For £3, bands will get 3 pots. For £5, you've guessed it, they could get 5 pots of noodles. So what will you do with your money tonight? Will you go home, just leave it in your purse or in your online banking? Will you choose to support an unsigned and underrepresented band? And what I'll be doing tonight, what about you? This.
So free, wouldn't hesitate to follow me through all the things that we do. The one day you turn around, threw our friendship on the ground for your own selfish reasons. With each and every step, I knew I'd be through with you, knew I'd be through with you. I had you back. But some things we can't share. My ex is one of those. Some kind of friend you were. I had you by my side. But some things we can't share. My ex is one of those. some kind of friend you wear. By my side for so long, I never thought you could be so cold. With all the things that you've done, number one was the one for me, but then you tried number two and three. I should have cut you free. With each and every step I knew I'd be through with you, knew I'd be through with you. I had you by my side, but some things we can't share. My ex is one of those, some kind of friend you wear. I had you by my side, but some things we can't share. My ex is one of those, some kind of friend you wear. Some kind of friend you wear. My ex is one of those, some kind of friend you wear. I had you by my side, but some things we can't share. My ex is one of those, some kind of friend you wear. 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 Some kind of friend you wear.
To James Rowan.
May rest in peace. Now, you lads also just released a brand new single, as I just said before, Some Friends You Wear. It's followed by a video, which is cracking. Sounds like a step up for you guys. It's a pretty solid production. Can we expect more of the same in the coming months?
Yeah.
Are you back in the studio recording, are you?
Yeah. We've been working with the guy who did the Kimchi demo, Jose Ibanez. We went back and we've gone back with Jose.
What
are
you
going
with the Ibanez?
It's Ibanez.
It's not
Ibanez,
because
the I is in Spanish.
But he's in
England,
lad.
Jose.
Joseph.
Joseph. Just call him Jose, and he's a sound engineer.
He works with Third Planet. Records, you know, in Box.
Oh, yeah.
Studios. And he's the sound of Skye, and probably a lot more talented than all of us put together.
Yeah.
He picks up a guitar and then it makes noises that
yeah.
we could probably only make if we got ran over.
Yeah, he didn't actually play anything on them. He played all
the
stuff.
That's the album that's on the negative, really. EP or album this year, what are you going to do?
Oh, who knows?
Because you've got quite a few songs anyway off the last EP, haven't you? Could you use them on the album, or do you want to
I think that's the main thing, is that we're not going to do an album. There's not going to be an album.
It'll be an EP, won't it?
Yeah.
Haven't you released an EP? It's more of a demo than anything else. It's the first thing we ever put out.
We were just getting used to sounds and the like, and you know, playing together at that time.
Mm. As unprofessional as we come across, a lot of the time, we put a lot of thought into how the guitars were going to sound this time, and we worked on making sure that a certain instrument sounded a certain way, and
like the bass sounding good.
Yeah. I mean, we looked into everything. We did. It's probably boring for people going to watch it, but we looked into the aspect of that strings play and what sort of sound we're looking from the desk.
The overall arrangements of the songs and things like that.
So we've, production-wise, we put a bit more thought into this. We haven't just gone in and gone, let's do some music.
Yeah. Well, I think it's important to get the production right, you know what I mean? If you're gonna say yourself as a big band and you're very serious about what you do, then it's important to display that, isn't it, you know what I mean? I had a quip the other day about these fellas sending me in playing the guitar, you know, and eating cheese buses in the bathroom and that. I'm not posting on Facebook, mate. It's like whenever anyone goes onto your page, they don't want to see a load of nonsense. They're fans of yours. They instantly want to be hit with material, you know what I mean?
They're obviously going to get nonsense if they look on our page.
They are, like, yeah.
See, Facebook page is reasonably professional. I think it's when you go on Twitter and Instagram and my Snapchat that it gets weird.
What are you doing in your private life? That doesn't come into play. Now, we've got you lads playing on our festival again this year, which I'm very happy about. Can we expect a bit more madness? You kind of stole the show.
No, this year we're going to stand and just play our instruments.
Oh yeah, whatever.
Maybe we should bring a gospel choir and we'll
That'd be amazing.
We'll go YouTube style this year.
And you can just have like a big cross on your back or something like that.
I might just be Jesus.
The Jesus of the festival.
Not of life.
It is the 5th of August now as well. We've just been confirmed. What other festivals are you going to play? Any other festivals this year?
I think we'll pretty much play anywhere and anyone gives us a chance.
I think you were good last time. You know, you brought a bit of excitement to it. So I think you shine really at festivals. I think that's something you should definitely look into. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm.
I think it's finding the right people to put you on in the right places. And I think Phil and I joked the other day about it. It was like we've not like for a band that's been around as long as this band has. We've not really done a lot, and I don't know whether that's as a result of everything that's happened with changes and such, but we've done okay. Think about it, we've only brought out 2 songs in maybe 2.5 years.
Yeah.
But you've got a big catalogue as well, haven't you, of music, obviously?
We just need people to take a chance on us, I guess.
You've got to get in touch with them, you know, because, I mean, even if you have to play outside of Liverpool, you know, there's so many festivals up and down the country that you can get on, you know what I mean?
Well, we have been getting out of Liverpool a bit, haven't we?
York coming up.
I encourage you. I think it's good because you also get a sense of what people make of you outside the city. You could go and play your gig in York and just be a sensation there.
We played Leeds the other week, and a phenomenal gig. I mean, It was so busy.
Was tell them what happened, John.
Which bit? The whole lot.
Well, if you can remember.
Yeah, if you can remember.
We drank a fair bit.
What then was it?
And I climbed over a fence and nearly roundhouse kicked some girl in the face.
No, there's no nearly about to get roundhouse.
Oh, roundhouse kicked a girl in the face. I didn't mean it, and I don't condone violence.
That's punk, though, isn't it? Isn't that what it's all about?
I don't think she was that punk. But I did also hit somebody in the face with a toilet roll. But the toilet roll was fun.
The toilet roll was fun.
I mean, it ended up all over the gaff. We threw toilet rolls into the crowd.
It's a good idea, that.
It's fun.
It's a gimmick, isn't it? I remember seeing Space Throne there blow up dolls up the stage and things like that. That was pretty cool. But anything you can sort of add to it, a gig like that, is obviously going to make it a little bit more interesting.
Well, I guarantee you come to see us.
Sausage rolls off the stage and things like that.
No, there's no way I'm throwing their way through. From towards me, I'm there.
Yeah. Do you know the story behind why I brought this? Do you ever remember your rant about Peppa Pig? That's why I brought it. Got to introduce it though.
Come on then.
Oh, do you have a go? It's their fun.
I work all day, working my band 9 to 5, and at night I feel like sleeping, but I can't stop thinking about what I should do while everyone else is sleeping. I say and say that there's a better way. I know won't work as well, but you can see while everyone else is sleeping, I'm lying awake and thinking, who the hell are you to tell me how to live my life and do my job? You never worked a single day.
To watch for you, who would you say are the best of the best at the moment?
In Liverpool?
Yeah, yeah.
Last Reserves.
Last Reserves, yeah. Yeah.
For me, Last Reserves. They're straight punk for me. And then you've got Bernie Airbook, they were phenomenal. As I said before, I won't carry on going on about them because I give Josh a massive head. But yeah. They're brilliant. And
Meet the Robots as well, they still fly and fly.
Yeah, they're. I think they are playing soon. I can't think where they're playing now. But yeah, we're playing with Bernie Airbook tonight, and
there's quite a few punk bands out there, though, isn't it? I think what I do like about these bands is that they are very professional. As you know, what I'm saying, like there's a million sorts of like indie bands and things like that, and they're all very half-assed. But I think if you are a punk band, though, you're sort of forced to be a bit more ambitious, aren't you?
Yeah, well, I think again, going back to what we were saying before, I think it's hard because a lot of bands, they have to, and I know one of the biggest bands that's come out of Liverpool on like the punk rock scene is a band called Waster, and they immediately had to look beyond Liverpool because there wasn't somewhere for them to be. They did a festival last year, sorry, a couple of years back, called Jump On Demand, and every band there, apart from ourselves and Meet the Robots and Waster, were from outside of Liverpool. So for 3 days, you had three days worth of gigs with bands that weren't from the city because there was just no one to fill it. I think that's what our aim is now. We're looking to find these bands and go, well, look, there's a home for you. That's
cool, that is. It's great, that.
I mean, like, we're not. I'd probably wage, and I imagine you two might agree with this. We're not the greatest musicians, but we're certainly.
Speak for yourself.
We're more about the art candy than the musicianship.
I think we're none of us are afraid to be honest, are we? So
yeah.
I think we can have a laugh, and we've got the balls to put shows on. And
I think part of the love for your band is the way you are. You know what I mean? And our listeners see me and you banter all the time. So we never stop taking the piss out of each other. You know what I mean?
I don't even like it.
I don't even like you. No.
They say we keep in touch with you, right? Because you'll play our music and put us on the internet. That's an intro, bad balance.
I'm like,
that's wisdom trees.
I do take the piss out of you a lot, don't I? It only doesn't know you can take it a lot, that's all it is.
I know.
Everyone else will get upset and slack, fine. Now, you're going to give us a bit of a stripped down set tonight, aren't you? Obviously, you're a heavy.
I wondered where that was going.
Obviously, you're a heavy punk band. But you're going to strip it back down for us acoustically. It's nice to see a punk band that can do that.
Can we play? What song is it going
to do? We don't even know. They had a bit of a heavy night last night as well, didn't you?
Yeah.
So, it's his fault.
What's my fault?
this goes on. He's already slagged my green screen off. He said it looks like a dodgy porn set. I think he commented on me Glass Miller's last time he was in. It's just terrible stuff, you know. I really look forward to having a band in the studio.
what other type, just clear this up. What other type of mirrors can you have apart from glass mirrors then, Doug?
Polish
metal.
Polish
metal.
Love
metal, that's a shout out actually,
yeah.
Hashtag corrected.
Yeah.
Not set corrected, but
yeah. Are we going to get any new tunes
from you today? I genuinely mean this when we said it. We don't know what we're going to play. What should we do?
I can play everything to an extent.
Okay.
So if it sounds shit, it's your fault.
We'll definitely have to do. You're your friend.
Yeah.
You real well?
Yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. Else?
And try and do
right anyway we'll talk about this off camera.